In this segment, we'll talk about finding an exact solution of ordinary differential equation which has a polynomial forcing function. So we're going to take this example. This is a first order ordinary differential equation. It has only first derivative terms in there. And if you look at the right hand side, which is 16x squared, the forcing function, it is a polynomial. Of course, we are given the initial condition, y sub 0 equal to 5, and we need to figure out what y is as a function of x. That's our goal. So how do we go about doing this is to we're going to use the classical solution technique in this particular example, which means that we have to find the homogeneous part and we have to find the particular part. And once we have found these two, we'll be able to find out what the value of what is the expression for our dependent variable y as a function of the independent variable x. So let's go and find out what the homogeneous part. The homogeneous part of the solution will be, let's look at the characteristics, should be 10 m to the power 1, that is this is the first derivative, so it's m to the power 1 plus 4 m to the power 0, because that's the zero derivative right here, will be equal to 0. So what we get is 10 times m plus 4 is equal to 0. And we get m is equal to minus 4 divided by 10, which is minus 0.4. And hence the homogeneous part is k e to the power minus 0.4x. Let's go and see how we can find the particular part. For the particular part, what you have to do is you have to think about, hey, what is the form of the right-hand side or the forcing function? And what are all its possible derivatives? That becomes your form of the particular part of the solution. So it'll be a x square. And what is the derivative of x square? It is 2x. So it will be of the form b times x. What is the derivative of x? It's 1. So it's a constant. What is the derivative of constant? It's 0. So there's no need to add that part. So that is the form of the particular part of the solution. Always that's going to be the case, except for an exception where if this, any part of this is any part of the homogeneous part, then you have to look at next independent solutions. But that's not the case here, so let's not muddle anything here. So that is your particular part of the solution. The question now is to how to find A, B, and C. So in order to find A, B, and C, what we basically do is we plug it back into our differential equation to be able to find what those are. So what we had was 10 dy by dx plus 4y is equal to 16x squared. And we had our particular solution to be ax squared plus bx plus c form. So we're going to plug it back in here. We're going to say 10d by dx is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c plus 4ax squared plus bx plus c will be equal to 16x squared. So you might now think that, hey, yeah, surely I'm able to set up an equation now to find a, b, and c, but there's only one unknown, one equation and three unknowns. How do I go about finding a, b, and c? Let's first find the derivative. So we get 10 times 2ax plus b plus 4 times ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 16x squared. So somehow what we have to do is we have to find out what a, b, and c are, but we only have one equation at hand. So the way to do it is to, let's see what the coefficients of the different terms of the polynomial are. What is the coefficient of x squared? What is the coefficient of x? And what is the coefficient of the constant terms? So that we can equate those and maybe we'll get three equations, three unknowns. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write x squared here. And what are the terms of x squared? Right here, 4a. That's the only x squared term. Let's look at the x terms. I get an x term from here, which is 20a. I get an x term from here, which is 4b. And let's collect all the constant terms I have here, which is 10b. And here I have 4c is equal to 16x squared. Now what I can do is I can write this as 0 times x plus 0. And how does that help me? It helps me that, hey, if I equate the coefficients of x squared term, if I equate the coefficients of the x term, And if I equate the coefficients of the constant term, then I'll get three quotient three unknowns, which basically implies that 4a is equal to 16, 20a plus 4b is equal to 0, and 10b plus 4c is equal to 0. So I basically have my three equations and three unknowns. And I should be able to find a, b, and c. If you look at equation number one, you directly have 4a is equal to 16, which gives you a is equal to 16 divided by 4, and that's 4. Let's look at the second equation. We have 20a plus 4b equal to 0. So 20a is 4 plus 4b is equal to 0. And then that gives me 80 plus 4b is equal to 0. And what does that give me? So I have 80 plus 4b is equal to 0. So 4b is equal to minus 80, and b is equal to minus 80 divided by 4, which is minus 20. Let's go and find, use equation 3 now. Equation 3 is 10b plus 4c is equal to 0. I just found b to be minus 20. And I'll be able to find what c is from there. So I get minus 200 plus 4c is equal to 0. 4c is 200. C is 200 divided by 4, and that's 50. So by solving these three equations, three unknowns, I have been able to find out what the values of a, b, and c are. So my particular part of solution is ax squared plus bx plus c. A turned out to be how much? 4. B turned out to be minus 20. And C turned out to be 50. So this is my particular part of the solution. Now, in order to find the full solution, y is equal to yh plus yp. And what is yh? We already found out the homogeneous part of the solution is something like this. The particular part of the solution we just found out, and that gives me the complete solution. However, I still have to find out what the value of k is, and the value of the k can be found by using our initial condition. So our initial condition was given as y sub 0 is equal to 5. So y we know is k e to the power minus 0.4x plus 4x squared minus 20x plus 50. I'm rewriting it because we're on a new screen here. So y sub 0 is 5 will be equal to k e to the power minus 0.4 times 0 plus 4 times 0 squared minus 20 times 0 plus 50. So if that's the case, I get 5 is equal to k plus 0 minus 0 plus 50, and that gives me k is equal to 5 minus 50, and that's minus 45. And now what that means is that I have found out all the things which I need to find. So y will be equal to minus 45, because that's the value of k, e to the power minus 0.4x plus 4x squared minus 20x plus 50. And that is my complete solution to this ordinary differential equation. If you have to find the value of y at a particular value of x, all you have to do is to substitute that value of x and you will get your value of y. And that is the end of this segment.